oyster reefs are critical to the health and fortification of our waterways and marine life, and we're losing them.
We have lost 85% of the oysters worldwide.
The University of Florida's Whitney Laboratory for Marine Bioscience has embarked on a holistic effort to restore Northeast Florida's oyster reefs to a healthy standard.
And the idea was to engage the public through citizen science programs to be a part of the restoration of oysters.
These bivalve mollusks are the equivalent of coral reefs in the tropics, providing a habitat and food not just for crabs and fish, but hundreds of diverse organisms. But oysters also provide crucial ecosystem services. They offer a barrier of protection to the shoreline, and their incredible filtration system helps keep our water clean. In fact, just one oyster can filter tens of gallons of water a day.
The pressures that create water quality problems are not going away. That's human impacts. And so we really need these guys to do what they do naturally to benefit us in our coastal ecosystems.
Problem is, oysters are being threatened by over-harvesting, pollution, and very visibly by boat wake and anchoring.
And what has happened is the oyster shells themselves that were once in the water here through boat wake activity have been pushed all the way up on the shoreline. And in fact, they're piled up. We call them oyster rakes.
Once a healthy oyster reef is pushed onto the shoreline and turned into rake, the reef dies. There is no material for new oysters to attach, to form a new cluster, and no reef grows, allowing the relentless battering of boat wake to eat away at coastal property.
So oysters are protecting the shoreline from erosion, literally. And that protection can be translated to dollars when it comes to property values.
Restoration of diminished oyster reefs is not a new thing, but here at Whitney Lab, we're advancing the work with a new sustainable initiative called CORE, Community Oyster Reef Enhancement Modules. The oyster modules were designed with three criteria. They need to protect the shoreline, catalyze oyster growth, and do it in an environmentally responsible way.
The community was concerned about the use of plastics, and they came to us, and then we designed something based on different ideas.
The material in the modules is plastic-free, easy to carry, and degrades over time, leaving behind no human fingerprint, and in 5 to 6 years, a stable oyster reef. Oyster larvae live in the water column for 2.5 weeks. These core modules, designed at Whitney Lab and built by community volunteers, provide a welcoming place for the larvae to settle and make a permanent home.
There are hundreds of baby oysters stuck to those shells, and they're going to grow into adults, and that reef structure is going to continue to expand as it goes.
Meanwhile, back here at the lab's hatchery and nursery, our ecologists collect local oysters and condition them to spawn. Then we give the oysters with spat, or babies, attached to the oyster gardeners to place in their gardens.
We give the oyster gardeners a cage with 20 to 25 oyster shells in it. They hang it off their dock and they go out and they routinely check on it.
And eventually, after 8 to 10 months, you have a full cage of oysters.
So I love it. And I get to get out here. I get to check the water temperature and we check the clarity of the water. I do that once a week. I do a quick look at the oysters that are growing in the oyster garden to try to keep up with a bit of a count about how many oysters I see on each shell.
More than 200 citizen scientists have participated so far in the oyster gardening project. Whitney Lab collects the thousands of pounds of live, matured oysters, and we move them to restoration plots.
And there's a lot of water to cover, so we want to recruit as many of you out there as possible to come participate with us.
We want to have an environment that people can live close to and near to and participate on and not put them and their families at risk. So maintaining a strong population of oysters is good for not just the wildlife, but it's good for all of us here.
This area of Northeast Florida is currently home to some of the best water quality in the state. How long can we retain that status? We need your support to continue this important initiative. Contact the Whitney Lab to get involved.